Welcome to You Make It, We Show It, the show that's all about your films. And thank you for sending them in. We've had films from Ireland and France and, of course, from the UK. I'm joined tonight by Nelda Pereira and David Netherton. Yep. We're going to watch these films. Let's see the first film.
What do you desire? What makes you itch? What sort of a situation would you like? Let's suppose, I do this often in vocational guidance of students. They come to me and say, well, we're getting out of college and we haven't the faintest idea what we want to do. So I always ask the question, what would you like to do if money were no object? How would you really enjoy spending your life? Well, it's so amazing. As a result of our kind of educational system, crowds of students say, well, we'd like to be painters. We'd like to be poets. We'd like to be writers. But as everybody knows, you can't earn any money that way. Or another person says, well, I'd like to live an out-of-doors life and ride horses. I said, you want to teach in a riding school? Let's go through with it. What do you want to do? When we finally get down to something, which the individual says he really wants to do, I will say to him, you do that and forget the money. Because if you say that getting the money is the most important thing, you will spend your life completely wasting your time. You'll be doing things you don't like doing in order to go on living. That is, to go on doing things that you don't like doing, which is stupid. Better to have a short life that is full of what you like doing than a long life spent in a miserable way. And after all, if you do really like what you're doing, it doesn't matter what it is, you can eventually turn it. You could eventually become a master of it. It's the only way to become a master of something, to be really with it. Then you'll be able to get a good fee for whatever it is. So don't worry too much. But it's absolutely stupid to spend your time doing things you don't like and to teach our children to follow in the same track. You see, what we're doing is we're bringing up children and educating them to live the same sort of lives we're living so that they may justify themselves and find satisfaction in life by bringing up their children to do the same thing. So it's all wretch and no vomit, it never gets there. So, therefore, it is so important to consider this question. What do I desire?
So that was If Money Were No Object by Fionn MacArthur, that film from Ireland. That the message seemed to me very simple, which is follow your passion and then the money will flow from that. What did you think?
Well, I think it's a nice video just to kind of remind us that, you know, to take a step back and think about what do we actually want to do with our lives and not just kind of strive for money and consumerism and this thing. It's quite a nice message, I think.
Are you following your passions in life?
I hope I do. I don't know.
I think you are. Okay, let's watch the next film. This is De l'ombre à la lumière, From Shadow to Light by Farewell.
Thank you.
Well, that was the mysterious French artist Farewell, bringing life to the Paris underground. David, the mystery seemed to be resolved in the last 30 seconds.
Yeah, it was really nice. It was really nice, really good composition of shots.
Yeah.
And I liked the way it was very slow, but at the end it kind of revealed itself what it was.
It was a bit of a mystery, and then it was resolved. Yeah. Farewell, we saw him doing some other stuff, didn't we, before?
Yeah, very, very, very similar sort of thing, always through the underground, that's quite...
A man who's following his passion.
Yes, quite.
Okay. The last film in the first half is called Figure in the Screen, and this is by Asher Finn. I think that was like my ultimate dream. Nelda, what did you think of that film?
It was an interesting piece. I like the facial painting, but I'm not quite sure what the message was. What do you think, David? This is your area, art.
I love art cinema. It's my favourite genre. It was interesting, to say the least. It was filmed well. I need a narrative. I need a story.
This show is all about showing the best digital films from all over the UK and from indeed from Europe. So it's great to show adventurous things that would never get on TV in any other way.
No, of course.
Yeah. Nelda?
Yeah, definitely. I do agree with that. I mean, with kind of art cinema, you don't always...
Join us after the break for more films. Welcome back to You Make It, We Show It. And this film is about friendship turning sour. Let's watch. Thank you. So that was The Ruse by Greta Sporer, Sophie Mortimer, and Millie Millington, A Friendship Turning Sour. Nelda?
It was beautifully made, but I was wondering, where's the conflict in the story if it's a friendship turning
where's
sour?
Where's the ruse?
Where's the ruse? I didn't quite understand. I think I need to watch it again. What did you think, David?
I thought it was very nicely shot, but again, yeah, where was the turning sour? What was the ruse?
And there was no dialogue? Did you like that?
No, that's fine.
I think it's fine. You know, sometimes you can tell a story. It's better to tell a story without the dialogue because the visual is meant to kind of convey the message.
Okay, let's go to Paris now. Alice in Paris.
Now, where was I? Oh, yes. Well, soon after we arrived in Paris, my mother was offered a job at a strip club at 3 francs a night, which was roughly equivalent to 10 bob. My father was not well pleased. He said, Doris, that's my mother, the cost of living is high in France. To which she replied, Adrian, that's my father, I get more if I took off my pants. Well, think again, mother dear, he said. I'll not agree to that on any terms whatsoever, unless they pay you twice as much and provide you with a feather. Now, the owner of this particular club was a man called Francois Lecoq, who used to go around with 2 pencils, one behind his left ear and the other one tucked in his sock. Francois offered my mum twice as much if she would do the indecent thing. She agreed, but said she wanted an ostrich plume, nothing tiny from neck, but a large one from wing. In the meantime, my father found employment with a veterinary surgery next door. I think he took a shine to the receptionist, 35, 22, 34. Well, I'm going now. But I'll tell you all next time about my young man called Reg. But I'm off to buy la viande et les légumes, which is French for meat and 2 veg.
Tim Andrews and Alice from Paris. David?
Tim Andrews again. That was part two of Alice in Paris. Pretty similar to the first one. Quite amusing.
You looking forward to part three?
Part three, yeah. I'm ecstatic about part three.
Okay, so let's move on. We've got a music video now, and this one's called Pearl. Music by Harry Cohen and Cyril Cottrell, and the video is by Carl Anderson.
A girl with a song to sing, just like a pearl born suffering. She sings to me as I go by, that's a tear you see in my eye. And you know why I cry when she sings to me as I go by. She sings to me, she sings to me, she sings to me as I go by. She sings of once upon a time, when things had rhythm, had rhythm and rhyme. Went back and forth, it all went wrong. You know the score, you know the song. Just hope someday she'll learn to fly and tell her story free from the wine on the day of glory when the sun will shine. And you know why I cry when she sings to me as I go by. She sings to me, she sings to me. sings to me as I go by.
Caroline Hanley and Geroid Sheeran in Pearl. It wasn't like Rihanna or Miley Cyrus at all, Nelda. Very modern video. What did you think?
Yeah, I like the fact that it's quite a nice and simple video. You don't always have to overdo it. So I'm just wondering, was he like a ghost then?
Yeah, I think he was a ghost, yeah.
Yeah.
Was it a hit or a miss?
I thought it was a hit. It was nice.
David?
Yeah, wait. Good. Yeah, liked it.
Okay. The next film is OAP Care, Breaking the Stereotype. Granny Goes Clubbing. So that was made by Brian Mark Mitchell. Can't quite read the rest. Wrong and Stello, looks like. Part of their degree course, and that was at Sussex University. Nelda.
Oh, I love that. I thought it was nice.
Yeah.
Does it show the stereotypical granny sitting home with a cat knitting? It was really nice to see that, you know, elderly can go out and have fun.
You didn't think the film was stereotypical at all? No.
They're trying to break the stereotypical image of a granny.
They were. David?
I would have liked to see the clubbing.
Yeah, so would I.
Yeah, it was good.
Definitely.
Nice little film.
Yeah, so thank you very much for watching this week, and we'll see you next week.